Hi, I'm Antonio Castilla. We will learn how to determine the visibility of a polyhedron, which usually call him find views and hidden lines. We must never trust our intuition. Our brain tends to see what they're used and not really there. We will check in this example. This is the projection of a cube. Almost everyone sees it that way. But why cannot this be otherwise? The only thing that has changed is that we consider hidden lines and what a view. But as we're more used to seeing a cube with the first way, our brain tells us it has to be when you may not. Therefore, we should not trust what we see, but must follow a set of rules. The first rule says that the outline of a projection is always seen. The outline is the line around the eye, and it's always been. The contour line is not real because it depends where you are seeing the body. Let's look at a couple of examples. These are the projections of a tetrahedron. In the front we'll outline these lines, and in the top view are these other. We practice a bit more with this hub. This is the outline in horizontal projection, and this is the contour in vertical projection. As the contour is always seen only, we must worry about the lines on the inside of the contour. Apply the second rule. Suppose two surfaces, one blue and one red. If we only look at one of their projections, what is above and below what, or what is in front and what behind? It is impossible to know just a projection. In the horizontal projection of the two surfaces, which is on top, will plug at the bottom, but in the top view we cannot know the height of each. For height we see the vertical projection, that is, we know who to whom in top plan view, but we must check it in the vertical projection. The red area is higher than the blue. Then red deduce that clog the blue, but in the horizontal projection and will draw in phantom. Now we apply it to the vertical projection. The surface is a head clog which is further back, but looking only the vertical projection cannot know the position of each. If we look at the top view we see that the blue surface is ahead of the red surface, then, in the front is the blue which will be seen and which is hidden red. So the second rule says, between two opposing elements in horizontal projection will be seen that it has a greater vertical dimension. Projection in vertical projection will be seen that in horizontal projection has greater separation. If one is seen, the other is hidden. In a more informal way we can say, what is further from the ground line is seen on the other side. In the tetrahedron, the edge was seen but lacked the inner lines, AC and BD. It's two opposing elements, i.e., they have no common point. This is important and we just have to compare opposing elements. To learn what is seen in the top view, you look at the vertical projection and the one with the highest elevation point will be the scene. In this BD case, I insist that is measured in a projection, but where it is drawn in the opposite projection, then BD is seen as AC is hidden. Do not think that if something is seen and hidden in a projection, so is the other. It may or may not coincide, so we must always perform the test in the two projections. to know what is seen in the front view, you look at what has more alienation in the top view. We see that AD is the one with more away, then in the vertical projection is drawn with a continuous line while BC is drawn with dashed lines. Easy? Right? In the cube, contour was seen. Now we need to compare two opposing elements. We could compare two edges as before, but there are many, so it will be more comfortable if we compare two opposite faces. I insist that it must be opposed, that is, who have no common vertex or edge, so we chose a face either as ABCD, and the opposite is 1, 2, 3, 4. To see what is seen in the top view, you look at what vertex has greater height in the vertical projection. Face A, B, C, D is D, has the greatest height, and face 1, 2, 3, 4, is 4. As 4 has greater dimension D, the face containing 4, i.e. 1, 2, 3, 4, it is seen in the top view and the opposite will be hidden. Remember that if a face is the opposite, view can never be seen. It will always be the opposite. The first rule, the contour is always seen, prevails over the latter. Thus, although the face ABCD is hidden, edges AD and DC are part of the contour, views remain so. There are still lines B2 and D4 to be determined. The rule can be applied as many times as you like. We could compare two other faces, but in this case we'll be more comfortable just compare the two edges that remain. In the front it is D4 has the greatest height, so it will be seen in the horizontal projection, while B2 will be hidden. The line is a view in horizontal projection does not tell us how it is in vertical projection. We compare the face ABCD with the opposite 1, 2, 3, 4 in the top view and see that 1, 2, 3, 4 has greater estrangement ABCD, so 1, 2, 3, 4 will be seen in the opposite ABCD, hidden. Contour lines should be kept views although some are on the dark side. Missing by checking the edges B2 and D4 and found that B2 in the top view has more away, so will be seen in the front, and D4 hidden. This is the final result. I insist that these two simple rules always apply. In the next video we apply them to other solids, prism, cylinder, cone and pyramid. A greeting from Antonio Castilla.